Okay, so moving on to the next mission of Pharaoh, which brings us into the Old Kingdom. Egypt is developing its wealth and its capital, and we're getting into new monuments. So, I guess let's get into it. We're getting into some real looking monuments, perhaps. The birth of the Old Kingdom. Selima, Oasis, secure the caravan trails, or Abu Elephantine, procure new wealth. Not sure if Abu. So Abu might make it easy to do farming. And Selima, I'm not sure, I guess this means we have to rely on trade a lot. I'm not sure if that's good. Trade and military? Let's give that a go. Oh, it's a big population.
Nebka.
Districts of homes.
Each governed by a local ruler called a Numa. Though this system may seem rigid, under his leadership, Egypt has grown and prospered and made many great achievements in arts and architecture. Merchant caravans. Oasis by oasis from deep within the African.
Rearing zone luxury goods. Routinely attacked by warriors from Libya, and even by the Bedouins. To secure these trade routes, Nebka, which is we establish a military post at Selima Oasis. Trees suitable for timber, the sale of which will help us to raise money to fund the establishment of this outpost. Then we need. So we'll have to importing ebony.
We obtain copper from our newly established mines and timber in the land of Sinai.
So we need to import it so that we can export it or give it to the rest of. Anyway, so kingdom rating of 55 should be fairly easy. Prosperity rating of 20 will be the big thing of getting this oasis outpost squared away. Culture rating of 20 is easy, and population of 3,000 should be fairly easy too. So, the finer things. Bigger and bigger places of worship. Cities will want to erect a temple complex to their chosen god. Addition of an oracle and an altar, each dedicated to other lesser gods. Okay. So, alright, and luxury goods. People prize certain other luxury goods which are available only through importation. So we need to harvest timber, which means we need like a timber harvesting building, go to the trees, send it to the storage yard, and rare and valuable commodity, blah blah blah, build, yeah, woodcutter. Warships, transport ships, blah. Alright, let's have a looky loo. Fairly. Fairly. Rough surrounds. here. So this is obviously our source of food. This is where we might put our primary settlement space here. And we're going to have to build a military, so we'll eventually have to get that around. But I guess the oasis is... What else can we do? Woodcutter, which means we'll have to import clay. Because we don't have good enough soil for clay. We can't make beer either. We won't be able to make papyrus. So... We won't be able to make anything, which means we need trade routes open. So, Timna will sell us some stuff. That's good. So Timna's where we need to get copper from. Menefa will sell us some stuff. They will buy nothing that we want. Timna will buy... nothing that we have. Timna will buy nothing that we have. These guys will buy wood from Bedu. Bedet will also buy wood. That's us. And Kerma. So Bidet is probably the first one because we want to be able to sell wood to them. We'll open that straight away. And we'll export anything over zero. Wood. And let's get building our colony. All of this. And all of that. And I'm gonna build my room. That's what we're doing. So it's a double road. There. Three, four, to there. One, two, three, 10. Inclusive. Get our bandstand. Bandstand's probably all we really need. Where are these guys going? Pretty sure they need... Okay, so there's a little road. Need water. Need housing. So we can build a village pass near there. That's cute. I might build my woodcutter and stuff like that down here. We need hunting lodges and granaries. Yes, I said granaries. Roadblock. Things, because we need to put a bandstand in there. That I'll probably get some extra housing. Yeah. And we need the bazaar. Speed it up, get some people coming in. Coming in from the north. Here they come. And we really don't have a lot of cash either, so we need to get those exports going fairly quickly. $2,000 even to get a temple complex. Who is set? God of destruction. Okay, let's keep him happy. Error is a reputation dude. Prevents crime. Makes employees more willing. Let's have a look. Food level's too low. We eat more than we need. Then we have assets have already fallen by 3,000. That doesn't sound right. How can assets have fallen 3,000? Oh, pavilion's worth 500. Maybe that's a bad idea to start with. Alright, we got overseers going. We need employees. People are coming in. Loads of people coming in. To the bazaar, that's good. The water guy to go past. Food and water are my priorities right now. Got the speed a little bit. The water guy is developing housing as he goes. Still don't have any people working in the hunting lodges yet. greenery. It's upsetting me. An overabundance across the kingdom. The price of purchase of luxury goods has fallen. This will reduce the profits to be made by exporting them. No shit. Yeah. Which I guess is an incentive to buy stuff. That's what they're saying. So we do that. And what we'll do is we'll create a little slum out here, I think. We'll keep these guys happy. And occupied. We'll give them water. Unemployment of 10%. Do the jobs. Most of these guys usually like. Which palace is a little bit X-y right now. Okay. Farmer house. Text post here. We want them to do. We want them to do a storage yard. So let's see how we go with no employment problems, which actually means we probably need workers soon. How is food? We produce much more than we eat. Let's be more clear about that. 800 people's worth. Not enough. Jesus. Food was all it took. What else do we need? Actually, let's check out housing. 200 more people. Let's do storage yard. Let's import Rodriguez. How much are they? Not important. How can you have unemployment of 25% but you're still not manning these fucking... There we go. What if I do that, guys? Is that gonna screw everything up? Let's just not do that. I really don't want this to go wrong. Work is live nearby. This is the frustrating thing. There are houses right here. Why aren't they operating stuff? Build another slum. Wanted it. Luxury goods. Pharaoh wants it. Where are we going? Pause for a sec. We don't collect most of the taxes. So let's get some tax collectors. Don't buy anymore. Stop buying it. How much are we getting for wood? Not too bad. 200. Oh, we've got plenty of food, so we can probably... Oh, we don't actually want to increase. I think it's too much. What do we need? What do y'all need? Pottery. Need pottery. Import pottery, but pottery is 140, or we can import clay, and then we can turn that into pottery, so let's do that. We import to maintain, like, 800. Let's have a look at properties. Firehouse, that's a bad thing. Otherwise, no problems. And we can get potter. We definitely have enough food, so it's good. There we go. Clay now. Yeah. Suppose I can put in a tax collector. I'm not really too concerned. Collecting them. We eventually have to get to 3,000 people, so we'll get this colony square away, then we might expand over to the other sides. Oh shit, I'm probably gonna need military soon too. Thank you. Oops. Oh, someone's just bought some wood. Let's speed things up a little bit. Maybe we can get some more wood going. We're gonna stop clearing the forest. It'll probably be useful. Okay, we have access to pottery. Access to pottery, exporting. Debilitating siege now strikes at current. That's terrible. We got a lot of people coming in. I don't really have jobs for you people either. Too many of you now. The granary is full. How much food do we produce? For about 1600 people, so that's cool. How's taxation? 500. Wages? 700. So we need to do better. We need to get these houses improved a little bit more, which is a beer thing. Can we import barley? Stop taking luxury goods and wood. You guys are going to take both, so that's fine. So we have one pottery place. To set and maintain 1,000. We'll do that with clay as well. Pharaoh wants some stuff. Let's send it to Pharaoh. Kingdom rating is good. Population is okay. Once population actually gets proper good, we can probably expand this and get like 2,000 people just here. Or 1,500 or something. It won't take much. Good. A military academy? What is that? Do anything with the military academy. Hey, we got Bali. So we got Bali, we got cash. We've got exports. We've got pottery. Good enough to keep people happy. We need culture. So how are we looking for culture? We're good for culture. We need a little bit more prosperity, so that'll come. Because right now we're up, which is good. Taxes in will get better. Exports. So exports we can expect close to 5,000. We can import beyond. We can import pottery. Can we export either of those? We can export beer. And we'll export beer. So maybe we do that. Maybe we create a beer enterprise as well. So this one will just be barley. And this one will just be beer. We'll get a couple more brewers going. Thieves just robbed our tax collector. You bastards. We don't have enough people. We don't have enough people. We don't know how to fix that. You guys are chopping that wood. Let's clear this dude out and make another. Set our barley import to 3,200. You are not going to take any more barley. If we have a barley thing, you're not taking barley. You're not taking barley. In fact, we're going to empty your barley. Yep, take a stretch of the brewer, that's good. I don't know what this idiot's doing. It's empty, that's empty your place. So we need to. Oh, what the hell was that? We got a year to fire off some Libyans. Oh dang. Looks like good enough beer. We're gonna set up a trade route to sell to men in the front. We're gonna sell beer that's over 600. 400. And because we're importing barley for 48 and we're exporting barley for 140. So that should be okay. That'd be a good turnaround. We've got the timber thing going. You're not taking beer. Get out of here with your beer. This is my clay pot request. So timber and luxury goods, clay pottery, barley, beer. Wealth. So we got people coming in. So 25 unemployed people means a dance school. We've got a company of archers almost. Can I import weapons? Or bronze? Can't I import weapons? Copper, sorry, copper. So they sell copper. Spend 1650 on a trade route. Temple complex. How's this? Unemployment 6%. Enemies. Yep. Assets are rising. We're 2 months from end of year. Plenty of food for everyone, that's good. Beer is going well. Pottery is going well. The wood industry is going okay. profit is good. We've just got to fight off this army. 6 months' time. Once we get a bit more cash flow going, we'll set up another settlement on the far side. Oh no. It is a long way from everything, so let that one go. They did their best. Let's go to the map. So Abiju, they buy a wood. No, that's wood. So they've got plenty of wood left to buy. Bedet does too. Minifer is buying beer. I do really want to open that trade route so we can sell more beer. Trying to import max barley. Get a bit of a beer empire going. Be beer barons. I don't know if this army is big enough either. I don't have the money to get the copper. I do have the money to open the trade route for copper. Yep, that guy bought some beer off us. So that's cool. Pharaoh wants the luxury goods. Kerma is under siege. The Egyptian army has engaged in combat that requires you to dispatch reinforcements there. Send troops. That's fine. I will actually be quite happy to send troops once I've protected the city. Copper is a little bit expensive. Let's import to maintain 200, and you guys can have copper as well, and weapons, and we will make a weaponsmith. And then we will get an infantry fort as well. Oh yeah, that's probably because I bought, what did I buy, barley? Yeah, we're back in the positive already. We've got a dollar to our name. A single Deben. And 1,000 people. But look at all the barley and the beer. 1,400 barley. This is going really well. So we're now exporting to Timna as well, because Minifer is no longer just a single consumer. What is that? What does that do? Thief! That's not good. Houses are devolving. Do we want to give them education? Don't think so. I think we need some police around the place. 1 month. Awesome. That's great. Great news. We've got almost 1, 2, Six archers short of two companies. And we got some copper. Our weaponsmith is making weapons. Unemployment of 6% is a good amount of unemployment, according to our government. A little more than we eat. About 1,200. Yeah, I think we produce a bit more than that. Maybe it's because the granary can't support it. Alright, I'm going to pause. I'm going to send some stuff to Pharaoh. I'm going to import a little bit. Oh, I can't import anymore because, what is it, Kemna? Kerma is under attack. So these baddies are over here, we're going to reduce our speed. And take control of our armies. Send in archers, maybe we'll bring them back a little bit. There's at least 7 of them. I was going to build a temple complex, but I haven't got any money. Why have I not got any money? Hopefully we can export that beer a little bit better. Who's this guy? Barley salesman. This guy is buying wood. I really have a lot of wood. Okay, so we're currently holding ground type formation. Till everyone gets set before we say engage. Oh, here we go. Engage and engage. Shoot them. I think this is going really well. We were just enough prepared. This guy's gonna buy some beer from us. Does anyone buy pottery? No. So we've still got 16 guys here. We've got 11 guys here. I don't think we've lost anyone. This is going great. You got unemployment? No. 24 unemployed people. We've got good population equilibrium. Yeah, shoot the bastard. Alright, they're leaving. Let's return to the fort. Thank you. Job done. Outstanding. So, what we need to do is dispatch some troops. who's out of serve military. Assign to kingdom's office. These guys. Send everyone. Alright. Yeah, dispatch them. Let us strip our defenses. We're still generating some soldiers. And we can pick up our speed again. That went really well, we've got enough food. Great. This is all going swimmingly. We have a single infantryman. Copper is expensive, so we'll get that. Infantry humans and buddies and get things rolling. I need to import I can't import luxury goods yet. Okay, so how's money going? So taxes are better than wages. Exports are twice as good as imports. So if we avoid construction, then the gravy. Oh, this is actually perfect. I need 3,000 people. That's all that's missing. So we can start working on our next colony over here. Colony. The next group of people. They have a food supply up here. Maybe I'll put it down here. Are we getting enough wood? We don't have any wood. Sell more wood to them. We can sell more wood to them. They don't want wood. And they don't want wood. But so we can sell more wood. Which means we can. Create some extra housing. What goes with housing? Water. Some health stuff. The amenities. Architect. Firehouse. Police. Tax collector. And then we go with woodcutting. I'll send you my luxury units, but now I really, really need to get them again, which means Kerma needs to get back in the game. Our guys really haven't left yet. Kingdom standing is good, which is a really good thing because it means we can stand to lose some if we can't export any goods. I think it will clear this forest after all. I need the room for the people. numbers might be reduced somewhat since they left, but their comrade's sacrifice was for the good of Egypt. Hey, we were victorious. Nice. What does that mean? Okay. How are our soldiers looking? Oh, dang. We have one soldier left? Dang. Alright, we got plenty of cash, though. What else do you people need? Nice. Trade to Kerma. Oh, I can eliminate it. We're coming in now. And we've got to maintain 400. That was a good idea. So put a granary out here. And we can get some extra hunters as well. There's one. There's a firehouse right there. Maybe tax collector. Send it. Architect. Firehouse. Tax collector. Temple. Did I get the temple complex? I didn't. Is on their way. What can I do now? I need to import reeds. Maintain. Sure. 400. You're also going to accept reeds. Maybe you can accept reeds as well. Another one. We got enough luxury goods in the meantime. We need a skew. We need a papyrus maker. Maker of the papyrus. Which we've got reeds now, and so we need a school. Yeah. Put a school in the district. That will be good. Allow us to beautify the place a little bit better. Well beautified. Probably unemployment over here. So we need... Nope, not bandstand. We need a school for our crusty jugglers. And our musicians. Yep, getting entertainment underway. Our priority is just to get population, really. So I can probably build one over here as well. Yeah, cool dog. Cool. I think I'm ready. Got a decent military. Kingdom rating is 93, so we're pretty good here. What do these guys need? Food? I don't need any food. These guys have a lot of food. They need pottery and stuff. A lot of people. This is a fairly unbalanced city, so what are we gonna do? We're gonna make a water supply. We're going to do something like 3, 4, 5, 6. Gonna put in a lot more housing here. And get another hunting lodge going out here. So that's housing. We need the bazaar. We need these amenities. fire. Architects. Maybe a shrine to set. Right. Maybe we slow down for a bit so our armies can respond. What are we doing? We're creating temples. They're set. You will need access to healthcare, dentist, apothecary, courthouse, a collector of taxes. Let's get another conservatory here and oh god. Engage them. This looks like it's doing itself. What else do we have? We're almost 2,000 people. Really need that food supply going. So, granary. Yeah, we're just gonna max out on housing. See if we can just crush it while we can. Do some beautification. Just to break the bank a bit, and then we'll call it a day. There seems to be more guys here. Prosperity is still pretty good because last year we lost money as well. It must have been pretty cash positive. Get them. Where's my other company? Guys are gonna die very quickly. I'll probably speed back up again. That's fine. Back to the fort, you good guns. Looks like we lost a whole company of archers there, so that's not great. Well, speaking of lost a bunch of money. Oh, we got all this stuff going, that's good. Population's almost cracking 2,000. Oh, what are you guys doing over here? We'd lose them, just we'd walk about. So these guys are well supplied. This bazaar has plenty of food, pottery, and beer. This is where we need to get our houses. Because look at this house. That's the business right there. And the rest of this slummishness is not ideal. But it's the best we can do right now. And we're looking at jobs. We need more employed people. What can we employ them doing? I do want to get that temple complex. I guess we need more brewers, right? Maybe. Maybe we can do some brewing a little bit further away. Maybe we'll put a storage yard out here. So this thing can take any. Gosh. This thing can take. Yeah, barley. Pottery. Yep, I'll do that in a minute. I need more potters, though. Cool. Nice. Archers are on their way. These guys are developing. We're up to 2,200 people. We have food. Let's get another hunting lodge, make sure there is enough food. People, and we've got housing for another 400. So we do need to. Too few jobs. What could we give them? Entertainment jobs? 10. 12. Why don't I make the temple complex? Fuck, that'd be cool. Notices. Pharaoh wants goods, we're in debt, and we've got a foreign army coming in 4 months' time. Pharaoh can have goods, but I really don't need to give them to him. And our guys are abroad, so that's not great. But we've got 16 infantry here, so that's fine. Temple complex, 50 employees. Poor access to workers. I wrapped a road around it. Pathetic. Got you a complex, bro. Housing for almost 400 more people. We do have people coming to the city too. But they need jobs. Tax collectors have 6 people, physician 8. Stop importing copper. Because that is expensive. People are annoyed, there's not enough jobs. Well, let's generate some jobs. What are you? I understand that this is a terrible way to manage a city by just doing what current governments do, which is just generate government workers. But I'm literally just trying to get to 3,000 people, which I know governments don't have this need to employ people in order to get to a population milestone, so. Cool. Special orders, you're only gonna accept up to half. Except pottery and beer. And we're gonna need more brewers. Obviously that's not where we get brewing from, because there's people not working there. Still in debt a bit, so that's not good. Are away. Being invaded while our army is away. So hopefully the infantry can take care of this. Just keep an eye on the map. So we have housing for another 356, which is enough. We have housing to get us to 3,000. This looks good. So much quicker. Kill them. Bloody Libyans. We still have 16 infantry soldiers, so that's good. It appears we didn't need that many. Can my kingdom standing go any higher? Best in Egypt, prosperity is good, culture is good. Just gotta work on that population growth. Stupid jobs. Keeping ourselves poor. Taxes doubled. Silly Libyans. My guys are skilled. They're encouraged, and they're kicking your ass. Population is stagnant while this is going on there, so that's annoying. At least we know this suburb works. The model for this suburb works. Oh, people are indifferent now, so they're not annoyed as much. No employment problems. With housing for another 460. We don't have anyone coming in because we're at war. Let's speed this up. Lack of jobs. Alright, back to the fort. Population is increasing now. We might actually finish this one pretty soon, if this is the case. Jobs. What jobs can I give these people? Still making weapons. Got a siege at Bedet. But our army is away. This population is exploding though. Yeah, This will go pretty well, I think. It's a terrible city. Absolutely terrible city. I'm not impressed with this city. I'm not proud of this city. I mean, I've got a very mediocre two-thirds of the city where I've got overuse of jobs generation. I've got a single suburb that works well, with a bunch of stuff around it that I don't really like. So, just gonna save here before it clicks over our population milestone. Because I'm pretty sure I've met all my other conditions. Culture, prosperity, kingdom. I don't know why my prosperity is still so high. Improve housing. If I could generate everything, that'd be fine. But I don't like that I have to import everything. It's just frustrating because you don't have control over it. I already have troops at Kerma. That's not cool, guys. Alright, wait, look, we got all these new people coming into the city. We're about to tick over our population milestone. I'm just gonna save it here, make it easier. Here we go. We did it. Booyah. Important trade route. We actually had a few important trade routes. Wood was not our most important export. Beer was. So trade is a really good way to keep your city in a good economic state. It's not bad. All right, cool.